Hey everybody, it's Jared with Big Mill Motorsports here. It's Tuesday night after our last race. I want to start this off with a big shout out to the Miller boys. Not this Miller, but Zach and Ryan Miller are down racing the summer shootout. And they're from right near me here in Ohio. I raced with those guys for several years. I think Zach won the first week in the summer shootout, and Ryan finished second. It rained heavily for the second week, and they finished somewhere, I think, in the top five, maybe top seven. And then I was just watching on my Legends Nation TV feed on my laptop here, and I see that Zach passed Ryan with a lap to go to take another win. So... Ryan passed Zach with a lap to go. So Ryan's got a win, Zach's got a win. They had 2 1-2s for some good guys up here in Ohio. So we're rooting for you. It was awesome watching that. They were already, I think Ryan was already leading the points coming into tonight. So that should give the Miller boys there a commanding lead in their pursuit to kick some butt down there at the Bojangles Summer Shootout. So, anyway, let's talk. Before the race, and I didn't bring this up on the video last time because I didn't think about it until afterwards, before the race, I ended up changing the jets on the carburetor. I did it because it was supposed to be a lot warmer out, so I changed the jets there. I did take a video of it showing removing the carburetor, changing the jets, putting the carburetor back on, all that kind of stuff. That'll turn into a how-to video coming up. So that'll be two videos that I'm still working on. The rear gear change and then now the carburetor and jet change. But anyway, I changed that before the race. I actually changed it on Thursday night. But either way, it was ready before the race. Went out, the car felt pretty good. When I came in after my heat race, I think it was, or after my first practice, the engine was stumbling quite a bit. So I ended up revving it up and cupping the carburetor a little bit, get some suction going and cleaning out the carbs, and ended up working fine throughout the rest of the night. I don't know that the jets made a massive amount of difference. My skill level doesn't afford me that ability, especially on dirt right now. The car felt really good all night. And I started fourth in my heat race, which means I qualified fourth in my group. I was fighting side by side with third place for most of the heat race, and I ended up finishing third. So... they instituted a new thing just to try out that night, and I think it's called the Pursuit Qualifying or Australian Pursuit Qualifying. So the top three in each heat race then went to the Pursuit Style, which is the two slowest people race, and the winner of that race is the next slowest, and the winner of that race is the next slowest, and they get all the way up to the fastest person. So you could effectively be the slowest person there, but if you race really good, you could actually race your way to start on the pole. So, finished third in my heat race. I raced the guy who finished third in his heat race, and I won that, which was cool. And then I raced the guy that finished second in my heat race, and he beat me. So, and then so on and so on and so on. But either way, I won what I won of them, which was cool. So I ended up starting the feature fifth, which was the third row inside, was racing. It was pretty darn good. I mean, I was racing in the between third and fifth place. I don't think I ever got to third, but more fourth and fifth place, really close to third place for the majority of the race. The car felt like it was really good. It's kind of one of those where I think if I was out front, I might have had a chance to hold some more people off. I couldn't get a clear line off of a lot of the corners or getting into the corners. And the guy behind me, you know, further on into the race was getting closer and closer and closer. And the car just kept getting more and more loose. And coming off of turn two, I got it a little bit hung out, got it a little bit sideways, and he ended up tagging me. I don't think it was intentional by any means, but watching the video afterwards, it was a little bit more of a hit than what I felt in the car. But either way, at that point I was running, I think, fourth out of 15 or 16 cars. And kind of a quick decision, and I do this far too often, but I spun the car and I grabbed, downshifted a couple gears and got it back up and running. And I think I ended up losing. I went down to 10th place. So I didn't go all the way to the tail with that. But as that happened on the backstretch, as I was coming around to the front stretch, they gave us the two laps to go in the race, which just sucked. So I did end up passing a car for 9th place and was side by side with a car for 8th place coming to the checkered finish line, or coming to the finish line. The car just felt like really, really loose. Like it got more and more loose after the race. Or towards the end of the race, and brought the car in. I was frustrated. You know, that was predominantly my fault for getting sideways there. But I felt my tires, and man, my right rear tire was hot, like maybe 3 times hotter than my left rear tire. So not quite sure what that means. I don't know if that means that I need to learn how to drive it a little bit better. If I had it a little bit too loose, maybe, or if I was trying to hammer on it a little too much. It was a dry, slick track, which is the same we've had for the last 3 weeks. So it shouldn't have been a whole lot different. But either way, I ended up finishing 9th. Car felt really good. I just wish I would have done more. I probably could have gotten a 4th place out of that. I really think I could have gotten that or held on to it. But either way, let's see, what are the things? So after the race, and in Legends, you don't really see a whole lot of disqualifications or anything like that. I'm packing up whatever, and I hear the rumors, whatever, that the race winner, who actually was the, had won 3 of the last 5 or 4 of the last 6 or something like that. And he's the guy who wrecked his car real hard last week. He had won the race in a borrowed backup car, which is pretty amazing. But I had heard rumors that he had gotten disqualified for tires, for a tire durometer. I didn't know. I wasn't about to go stir up anything like that. But it came out, I don't know if it was today, Tuesday, or yesterday, the Ohio Valley Roofers Legends posted that he did get disqualified for the durometer reading coming out too low. And was disqualified, so he lost all of his points for the night. And it's just interesting, you know. It is a legitimate disqualification. It's not a, you know, it's unfortunate. In Legends, you kind of learn, you know, there's a difference between cheating and kind of unintentional type things. And in our series, they pretty much only check 3 things every week, and that's your wheelbase, your track width, and your tire durometers. And this guy having won, you know, 4 of the last 6 or whatnot, he knew they were going to check his tires, and I don't think it was intentional. I can't imagine that it would be intentional. So it's probably just some sort of unfortunate fluky thing. I don't know if he's got a bad set of tires. It's legit. I mean, if it measures it, it's bad, but I can't imagine that they intended to do that, knowing that the tires were going to be checked at the end of the night anyway. It's either that or they were experimenting with some fancy stuff and it's finally come to bite them, but I highly doubt that. So either way, you don't see it very often in Legends, but the winner of the race got disqualified, lost all the points for the night, heat race points, show up points, feature points, all that kind of stuff, which is unfortunate. I'm imagining that he'll be back next week and he'll be kicking everybody's butt again with a different set of tires. Either way, that's just kind of how it goes. Unfortunate, but that's how it goes. So we are not racing next week. The series is racing at Portsmouth, which I really wish we were going to, but we've got some family event that we're going to next weekend, so I won't be able to make it. Our next race will be July 3rd. that's a Monday night. And so they're doing their big fireworks show, and that's the big Brush Creek show, I guess. That's where they get a lot of fans. Should have a good car count. Should be really fun. Car felt pretty good. I'm going to assume that it's going to stay pretty warm over the next couple of weeks. I mean, heck, we're in July, right? Or we're in June going into July. So I'm going to leave the carburetor jetted the way it is, leave the rear end gear the way it is, and leave the setup the way it is. I didn't make any changes in the setup throughout race night. And the car felt like it was coming to me, at least until later in the race when it got too loose, which I just have to maybe watch more of the video to see if that was caused by my inability to drive well, or if maybe I had the car set up just a little bit too loose. So either way, I'm just going to change the oil filter on the car, nut and bolt everything, make sure everything's good to go, and then I'm done. So that's really over the next 2 weeks. That's all I've got to do. Next week, because we're not racing this upcoming weekend, I'll do another vlog video next week. But what I'm going to do is do more of a tour of the shop that we've got here, our shop. I've shown a little bit of snippets of it throughout the last year. And as of the last couple weeks, I was really getting things narrowed down. You can kind of see in the background here, if I can point right. We've got some signs up on the walls and some dry erase boards. And so I've got some cabinets up and things like that. You'll kind of get a better idea of how our shop is. Hopefully I'll have it a little bit more cleaned up because it's still kind of a mess. But I'll do a video of that next week. And then again, July 3rd will be our next race. So if you have any questions or anything, any comments, go ahead and leave them in the comment section below. Follow our Facebook page for regular updates. And subscribe to the YouTube channel here. And I will be working on the how-to videos as we go. All right. Well, thank you for watching.